Ladies and gentlemen, happy Father's Day, and please welcome the winner of the 124th United States Open and the winner of the 1,000th USGA Championship, two-time U.S. Open champion, Bryson DeChambeau. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the CEO of the USGA, Mr. Mike Wong.
Anybody have any fun today? To my neighbors in Pinehurst and the Carolina Golf Association, it's pretty clear you are great at three things: championship golf, friendliest people in the game, and world-class humidity. You know what makes this place amazing? 225,000 people walked through the gates in the last 7 days. 4,200 volunteers and 2,000 volunteers on a waiting list. And NBC covered this event with a team bigger than they take to the Super Bowl. What a week. If you think this week was as great as we think this week, there's two people we really need to clap for: the USGA Championship Committee Chair, Kevin Hammer, and the U.S. Chief Championships Officer, John Bodenhammer. When you play a U.S. Open, you're really just hoping for one thing: the greatest track in the world that'll bring out the best and the best golfers in the world. The highest honor we offer at the USGA is called the E.J. Marshall Platter, and that's for preparing a golf course for a true championship. And we don't give it out all the time, but this year we voted unanimously that John Jefferies and his team at Pinehurst, number two, deserve the E.J. Marshall Platter. Give it to him, Courtney. One thing that's clear: when you win a championship like this, you don't do it alone. It's a team effort. And a couple of years ago, we decided we need to recognize that team effort. So join me in congratulating the 2024 U.S. Open Caddy Award winning Greg Bodine. Congratulations, Greg. And now to recognize our low am and the U.S. Open winner, please welcome me in joining to the stage the USGA President, Fred Perpall.
Thank you, Mike. This year's U.S. Open field included 16 amateurs, three who made the cut, earning low amateur honors with a score of 286. Please join me in congratulating Neil Shipley of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Congratulations. And now it is my honor to welcome the champion of the 124th United States Open and the 1,000th USGA Championship. With a score of 274, the Jack Nicklaus gold medal for the winner of the 124th U.S. Open goes to Bryson DeChambeau of Grapevine, Texas. To present the historic U.S. Open trophy given annually to the winner of the U.S. Open.
Congratulations, Bryson. I heard you wanted to wear that hat. We'll talk about Payne Stewart and his legacy and his memory in a second. First off, you're reunited with this trophy. And let's discuss when you won in 2020 at Wingfoot. Your walk-up 18 was just polite applause, like a Thursday morning out on tour. You didn't have all the fans. That was during COVID. You were engaged with the fans unlike any golfer we've seen before. What was the connection with the fans and you this week? Why was it so powerful for you?
Well, Mike, first off, I want to say happy Father's Day to every father out there. And unfortunately, my dad passed a couple years ago, and this one's for him. Also to Payne Stewart, he was the reason why I went to SMU. He's the reason why I wore the cap. Pony up, that's right. go SMU. Wow. I just can't thank you guys enough for all the support this week. You guys have meant the world to me. You are the best fans in the world, and I can't thank you enough. What a group of people. To my team that's growing quite a bit, and to my best friends and the people that I love the most, I'm surprised you're here. Not really surprised, but I can't thank you enough for being here. You guys mean the world to me, and I would not be here without you guys. I really appreciate it, team. Thank you all.
A couple of questions about the round.
Yeah.
Have a lead, get to the 13th tee, you're two back. Obviously, with where you were and Rory was, you guys could keep an eye on what was going on. Give me your mindset on 13T and how you found the way to steer it home.
Man, I felt like I was hitting the driver pretty well today. It just wasn't starting exactly where I wanted it to. And ultimately on 13, I knew I had to make birdie there to give myself a chance, as Rory was going on a heater. And he slipped up a couple on the way coming in, and I just kept staying the course, focused on trying to as many fairways as I could, even though I didn't. I was not great today with that, but I got out of trouble really well. And then, man, I can't believe that up and down the last. That was all world, probably the best shot of my life.
Would you like to see it? Yeah. Look up at the monitor up there. 55 yards, tell us about it.
Hit and hope. No, I was just trying to land it pretty much where I landed it and run it out to the right. I remember Payne's putt and how it broke up there, and I knew that was obviously huge to get up and down to win this prestigious championship that will be the highlight of my life. I still can't believe it. It's unbelievable.
You've become the 23rd individual, as you look at Payne Stewart, who's part of this group. You've become the 23rd individual to win multiple U.S. Opens, one of whom is back here, two-time U.S. Open champion Andy North. You're in a special and select club in American golf. What does it mean to you to have this baby for the second time?
Well, first off, I'll say to the USGA, thank you for hosting such an incredible event. Mike, you've done a great job. John, fantastic. Fred, you're the man. You know that. I love you, bro. And I'll tell you, the most important thing is the greenskeepers and greens crew out here. They did an incredible job keeping this golf course in spectacular shape. Thank you very much for your continuous hard work every single day out here to keep this championship the way it needed to be. So hats off to you. What it means, I haven't really let it sunk in yet. And tonight, I want all of you guys, somehow, I want you guys to touch this trophy, because I want you to experience what this feels like for me. You are a part of this journey this week, and I want you to be a part of it for the after party.
All right. The after party is funded by Bryson. Ladies and gentlemen, 2024 and now two-time United States Open champion, Bryson DeChambeau. Game back to you.